Say Telvin.
Say what's I don't fuck with these, cause they shady. These, they just wanna have my baby. Born in the 80s, Kurt, baby. Damn. Mama, she was in the street, so guess who raised me? You motherfucking right, couldn't get it from my mama, so I got it off the block. Been working my whole life, but I ain't never punched a clock. 9 years old, I seen them get shot. Damn. Quick to run they mouth when they get jammed. Tell it on his own fam. The same that you break your neck for. Be the same that cross you out and wet you up. Supposed to be chasing money, but you chasing.
What you doing?
Real bosses don't talk, we just sit back and listen. Stack that paper up and then make boss moves. She like to argue, so I sent that to law school.
Keep it real with your dad no matter what.
Free. Same decline she love you, she'll set you up. Free.
Out here in these streets, it ain't no such thing as love.
Free. The only thing I trust is this Danny Shrug.
Free. Real. Only when I do speak.
If that don't work, he'll fucking leave.
Free. I ain't got shit for it. Ain't nothing in this motherfucking world free.
Free. Zay got the mother bass thumping. Dolph got the mother trap jumping. Doors to the trap open, I sell you something. Hell nah, don't ask, I ain't fronting nothing. Your bitch and told her I see you around. Dog just skipped town with 200 down. Dog just pulled her in the 2 liter pop. They say Dolph addicted to these streets just like his pops. Addicted to hustling, I can't stop.
Won't stop.
Never hear me complain about what I ain't got. Cause if I want it, I'ma go get it. Free my nigga, yo, did it. Got paper round tatted on your. Same, you getting high with, he really your enemy. Every day, cross they partners out for Benjamin.
You keep it real with your dog no matter what.
Free. Same, decline she love you, she'll set you up. Free.
Out here in these streets, it ain't no such thing as love.
Free. The only thing I trust is this Danny Shrug.
Free. Real. Only when I do speak.
If that don't work, he'll fucking leave.
Free. I ain't got shit for it. Ain't nothing in this motherfucking world free.
Free.
What up, what up, what up, what up? Y'all know I had to rock it on out with that Dolph. He said some real things in that joint right there. I had to play it. That's kind of like the mode I'm in right now. You babies are right. Ain't going to be no game playing today. However, this is really about me bigging y'all up. Okay, and I'm going to explain to you what I mean by that. Because there's some things that I witnessed today. It kind of just got me looking at a lot of people like they goddamn crazy, like they had lost their damn mind. But you know, again, everybody's an internet gangster. Everybody could talk cool on a keyboard and all that and come and tell you and dictate to you what they think you should be doing and all that type of stuff. And still explain something to y'all about that. Explain something to y'all. Before I go into it, first I'm going to say shout out to everybody that supported me thus far. Okay, let me just say that first. Shout out to my hardcore followers, my supporters, those who have been on my lives every time, those who come support me on YouTube, those who support me on Instagram, those who purchase my oils, those who just really appreciate the efforts that I put out there that don't take the things that I do for granted. I first wanted to say thank you for that. Thank you for the blessings that you sent to my Cash App. I really appreciate that. And also, I heard some of the feedback that you guys have given me throughout the time that I've been dealing with you guys, which is going to bring me into my next subject. But what I'm going to talk to you guys It's about the law of reciprocity. Because there's a few of y'all out here that don't seem to understand what the law of reciprocity is. I want to make sure you guys are clear about one thing as it pertains to me. Now, I can't speak about you and how you decide you're going to go about things. But what you're not going to do is to tell me that the way you go about things is the way that I should be going about things. I don't give a damn about how you're going about things as it pertains to my business. That's number one. Let me get that straight with y'all right now. How you choose to move in your life don't have nothing to do with me. Okay? That's first and foremost. Number two, I am a manifester. Okay? I don't operate with a poverty mindset. Period. Okay? Now, I am sensitive to the fact that there are people out here that are struggling. I get that. Okay? I struggled once too in my life and worked very hard to get out of that space of struggle. All right? So you're not going to discredit the efforts and the hell and the journey that I've been through to get to where I am now. That's what you're not going to do. You're not going to gaslight me. You're not going to sit up here and say that you're not going to acknowledge the fact that your ass is projecting because you don't have shit. And we're not going to play broke games because I don't play broke games. Okay? I don't play broke games with nobody. I don't live in that space. Okay? Now, for those of y'all that are looking for solutions on how to get out of your situation, we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about manifesting your way out of poverty. We're going to talk about a bunch of things today. But what you're not going to do is you're not going to place your limitations on my life and tell me how I should be doing things. That's what you're not going to do. If you can't afford me, then your ass can't afford me. Go find somebody else you can afford. If you can't afford me, it is what it is. Now, I put something up on my Instagram today and on my website, shopisiswisdom.com. And I did this because of a lot of the feedback that my followers have gave me saying, hey, why don't you do something like offer an advice page or offer an option for us to be able to speak with you per my followers on the DMs. So I've been playing around and rolling around with it. I said, okay, I finally decided I'm going to do it. I even bounced the idea with a couple of friends of mine, just to bounce the idea, said I'm going to do it because I usually don't make myself that accessible unless you're getting a spiritual consultation from me. I've been very hardcore about being in that space. But, you know, some suggestions were made to say, look, make yourself a little bit more accessible. Okay, cool. Now, you guys are not paying for the questions for those of you that are goofy enough to think that stupid ass shit. I saw them dumbass comments you guys were making in my damn post and I didn't appreciate it. I said, you guys don't even take the time out to read. What you're paying for is my time. And I'm worth the value of my time. And if you don't take time out to value yourself, then it ain't got shit to do with me. Maybe you should take advice from the page over here and learn how to value your damn self. Okay? You sitting up here talking about, oh, well, people reach out to my page, I get 20 people. I got over 60,000 followers on my damn Instagram. Do y'all have any idea how many people hit me on the Instagram? How many people fill out my email that's attached to my Instagram? How many people that have access to the number that I give out? How many people DM me on my phone? I don't even answer that number. That phone's on voice. That phone goes straight to voicemail. You can only text me to get a hold of me. Y'all have no clue of the amount of people that reach out to me on a daily basis. You don't have a clue. But yet you're going to sit up here and you're going to tell me how I should be doing things because you ain't got shit popping in your life. You better get your broke ass up out of here with that bullshit. And when I say broke, I mean broke mentality. I'm talking about broke mentality. Poverty mentality. Self-entitlement mentality. That's what I'm talking about. Those who don't know shit about reciprocity. You think that someone should give up their time and effort for your ass? And you already showing me how much of an ingrate you really are by letting me see your ass come out of my page like that. Ingrateful ass fools. I give you YouTube. I give you Instagram. I give you magic. I give you all different types of shit. I give you my time when I don't have to. But you want to bitch and complain when I actually say that, hey, I got a way for you to get access, but you're going to have to cut the check, though, because my time is valuable. People sit up here and ask you dumbass questions all damn day. Questions that don't make no sense, but they don't have the ability to think for themselves. So here's my thing. If you're going to want to get my time, you're going to pay for my time. You don't have to rock with it if you don't want to. I'm not forcing you to do anything you don't want to do. But you guys are going to start learning something about reciprocity. Nothing in this world, I don't want to make sure you guys are clear. You are going to pay for something. Even in spirituality, you're going to pay for something. If you want to go out here and you want to buy a new pair of sneakers, you're going to purchase it. If you want a new purse, you're going to purchase it. If you want some new clothes, you're going to purchase it. If you need to go see a life coach, you're going to purchase it. If you got to go to a doctor, you're going to purchase it. If you want some food, you're going to go purchase it. Do I need to keep going on and on? Do I need to keep going and on? Y'all the same folk that'll come out here, bitch complain about somebody putting up their time and effort to get compensated for it, and then turn around and spend $1,000 on nothing. You'll go spend $20 or $40 or $100 some dollars on some weed. Don't get me started. See, the problem here is called prioritization. If you want something, then you spend money on what you want to spend money on, right? But then you get mad at the person when I'm just doing what I'm supposed to be doing. Make it make sense. It's always going to be an even energy exchange all the way across the board. And I'm not making y'all, none of y'all get my sessions or none of that type of stuff. Although I'm a good 30 in now. You know what I'm saying? Because I put that post up. But the point I'm trying to make is that whatever it is that you're doing, and you're deciding to give your energy out there to people, and you have an expertise or a skill at something, and you're constantly giving your energy out over and over and over again, and you're not receiving anything back in return, that's your fault. See, what that all boils down to is knowing your worth. That all boils down to self-love. Okay? That's what that all boils down to. Self-love. Because if you had self-love, this wouldn't even be a discussion. This wouldn't even be anything to talk about. And so what you're witnessing, and a lot of people hate it, is the fact that I have self-love for myself. So instead of you seeing it from a different perspective, you're seeing it as though I'm responsible for the entire world. Let me tell y'all something. I've been having a conversation with y'all about this for quite some time, about changing your reality. Learning how to manifest your reality. Changing what you decide that you're going to tune yourself into. A lot of you guys are full-fledged in on this so-called pandemic, and you guys are caught up on that. And so because you're stuck in that energy sphere, which is lower vibrational frequency, by the way, and all y'all on this live know I don't operate like that. I don't operate on low. I'm not doing it. Okay, so you're tapping into a lower vibrational frequency, and you're tapped into the things that these things that the TV's putting spells on you and telling you about on a consistent basis. You're tapped into that energy. So then you fall for that, right? Let me put y'all up on game about something. Unbeknownst to what many of you guys may not be aware of, just as many people as you see that are struggling out here that you're tapped into, there are more people out here that are not going through that struggle, that are very successful in their life with whatever it is they chose to do. Okay? And they're not millionaires. They're not none of that. They're just moving forward with their life and doing what they got to do because they know not to get caught up in certain aspects and certain frequencies, which is a very simple thing for most of you guys to do. Don't come to me and say, we're in the middle of a pandemic and I'm charging this, that, and the third. Hell, you know what's so deep about it? What's so deep about it is none of y'all even took the time out to even say, hey, I'm having a hardship. Would you make an exception to the rule for those that are in a hardship and give me the opportunity to even respond to that? There's no conversations even being had. It's just, oh, this, third, and third, you're charging this and you're charging that. And to me, that really ain't no damn money. That's chump change. Hell, you're going to pay that on the damn pair of sneakers you're going to buy. So I'm sitting up here and I'm just really thinking about the mentality of the people. Now, I know some of these people are new. I know some of y'all new. Y'all don't know who I am. I suggest for all the new kids on the block, y'all go check out all my lives on Instagram and go check me out on YouTube so you can get to know who I am and what I'm about. That's first and foremost before you pass any of your fake ass unqualified judgment over here. First thing you need to do, honey, is look in the mirror and judge yourself and find out why your ass ain't where you need to be at before you start jumping your ass on over here. And new is not an excuse. You're absolutely correct. That's what I'm saying. It ain't no damn money. But I'm looking at the responses from the people. Oh, I had such respect for you. Get your disrespectful ass off my damn page. Get your ass on. I don't need that kind of respect. I don't need the kind of respect where people feel like you should be where they are. I'm off that. That was that mastered that 15 years ago. People that aren't, that don't have things going for themselves, want to hold on to you, and then as soon as you make any power moves to do what you got to do for yourself, all of a sudden it becomes a problem. That's what you call a crab in a barrel mentality. Okay? That's what you call a crab in a barrel mentality. Universal law states that whenever you want to acquire something, you must give of something. You must sacrifice of something. You must give of something of yourself. You must give energy. Okay? This is the reason why a lot of people are in a position of poverty, because they don't understand this. A lot of you guys put yourselves in a position of poverty due to you just simply not falling through in the commitments that you made to yourself. Then you're not following through in the commitments that you made to others. Okay? You're not following through. But the most important thing is you're not following through the commitment you made to yourself. People don't realize that, but do you know that that puts you in a state of poverty? When you don't follow through on the commitments you made to yourself? Ain't that crazy? And then things pile up and things pile up and things pile up, and then next thing you know, you got a whole shitstorm full of nothingness going on that your mind is focused on, and you can't manifest because you didn't did all this over here, and now you're not in the position to manifest from an energetic perspective. You have to give your offerings and you have to pay your respects all the way across the board. For those of y'all that are out here and you have gifts, if you have products, whatever it is that you're good at, do not allow individuals to come into your space and tear you down and tell you that you're wrong because of what you charge, as if they were going to financially support you anyway. Yeah, I never take notice the people that say the most shit have no plans on supporting you anyway. You ever take notice of that? The people that talk the most shit have no absolute plans of ever supporting you anyway. Ever. Exactly, transcendent consciousness, that is correct. Not only do you pay for my time, you pay for my experience. That is absolutely correct. And knowledge base. You're not paying for questions. For those of y'all who thought that, you're not paying for questions. You're paying for my time and my knowledge base and my experience. That's what you're paying for. Period. Point blank. You got an issue with it? Go find somebody else that you can book a session with. I decided to give some of my time open to people who were receptive to it. And quite a few people were receptive to it. Because it's a way for them to get access, and we could talk, we could breathe, we could do whatever during that time period. Okay? But disrespect will not be tolerated. And that's the whole thing that I'm on right now, is this whole disrespectful thing. There's too many self-entitled folks out here. And you self-entitled folks, I got a little message for you. If you seriously think with that mentality that you have, you're going to make it going into next year, you are sadly mistaken. And if you haven't noticed, it has been working for you thus far. I don't know what the hell makes you think it's going to work for you next year. No, they don't. A lot of people that come in, they don't realize how much I pour into the work. They come on the page, they make their little comments, they say whatever it is that they feel like they need to say, and then that's the end of it. All I'm saying is that you guys have got to learn the law of reciprocity so you can begin to start bringing abundance into your life. That's how this works. You should be happy to compensate somebody for their time if they're making it available to you. You should be very appreciative, and you should have gratitude for that. Period. I talked about in one of my lives called The Three Things That You Need to Ascend. I talked about gratitude. I talked about humbleness. I talked about appreciation, all those different things. And some of you guys, not all of you, but some of you guys are still not getting it. Okay, some of you guys are still not getting it. There are plenty of, I love you too, Barack Hills Garden. That's my baby. But I want to say to y'all that we have been following in this poverty mentality because of others for far too long. When I do my money consultations, you know, what I discovered is that you have people that are taking on poverty mentalities from their parents, poverty mentalities from their other loved ones, grandparents, et cetera, that has absolutely nothing to do with them. I want you guys to start taking a step back and thinking about where that comes from, where the concept of lack comes from. Where did you learn it from? And why do you feel like that you have to live a program that was not yours and that you never created for yourself? This is some real shit right here. Some deep shit right here I'm about to talk about. Because a lot of y'all have adapted on certain mentalities and thought processes that were never your own. If you take the time out and you sit back and you think about that for a moment, you'll begin to realize that lack, not having, you learned that from somebody else. The question I'm going to ask you is why have you adapted that into yourself? And I don't want to hear no damn preacher ass, religion ass, oh, if you spiritual, you supposed to do this and you supposed to do that. Y'all better get the hell out of my damn face with that bullshit. Because I want you guys to understand, I'm operating in goddess mode. God mode. God mode means we manifest our destinies. That's what that means. You are not subject to your destiny. You create your destiny. Make sure you're clear about that. You create the destiny. You control the destiny. You manifest your destiny. You are not subject to your destiny. Do you understand what I'm saying to you, babies? You are not subject to chance out. You're not subject to all these different chances out here. You actually got a lot more control over your situation than what you realize. But you were taught through religion to think something different. And those just got that religious spirit, that religious poverty mentality, I can't do nothing for y'all. That's a program that you guys are going to have to learn how to break out of. And stop being jealous over everybody else that goes out here and manifests for their lives. Got the nerve to call somebody, sounds like a preacher in the pulpit syndrome. Well, again, take your ass on over here and you sit your low vibrational, non-manifesting ass down over there and you can watch me win from the sidelines. That's how that gonna go. See, what y'all need to understand is no matter what any of y'all say, I'm gonna keep rising because it's in my destiny to do so. Period. I'm manifesting that for myself. Okay? And I'm willing to help people manifest that for themselves if they're willing to learn. But if you ain't willing to learn, that ain't got nothing to do with me. That ain't got nothing to do with me. And make sure you guys understand this. You are not responsible for the world. You are responsible for yourself and your children. If you have any. You are not responsible for the whole world. So take that weight up off your shoulders, baby. Go on and brush it off your shoulder. You know what? You know what? Because I realize the world will take care of itself. That doesn't mean that you're selfish. That doesn't mean that you're self-centered. It means that you are taking the time out to take care of yourself. And if more people did that more, it'd be a lot more. This would be a happier place. Period. Take the weight off your shoulders, babies. Stop walking around carrying the weight of the shoulders of everybody else. Stop taking on everybody else's problems and neglecting yourself. Stop doing that, babies. I see so many people out here taking on problems and weight in other people's issues that have nothing to do with them. And they're trying to solve everybody else's problems. Well, if you're going to do that, at least get them to cut the check for it, honey. At least do that. So at least you're getting some energy back from it. Shouts out to all my pocket cat, all my pocket watchers, account coiners. Shout outs to y'all. And let me tell y'all what I do with y'all energy. I'm gonna share a little secret with y'all, purposely. You see, when y'all send me negative energy, y'all, I've already made it very well known to y'all that I practice magic. That's a very well known for me, and I know how about energy, I know how to manipulate energy, and I know how to control energy. Okay? Every time y'all send me negative energy, let me tell you what I'm doing with that energy. I'm taking that energy and I'm manifesting it into something positive for myself, and I'm manifesting it for myself. So I appreciate all the people who send me negative energy. Thank you. Thank you very much. The fact that you're even putting energy on me, I appreciate that. I'm going to tell y'all something. Y'all should learn that technique. Y'all should learn that technique. Helping ungrateful, lazy ass people. Exactly. That's one of the reasons why I brought that Dolph on there, because Dolph made said something very real. You know what I'm saying? These folks will be so quick to turn on you so goddamn fast. These folks kill me. Oh, she bring out the money wine. She ain't do this enough. I hate her now. But if I give something to myself, I love her. I love her. I love her. I don't need that fake ass love. No, thank you. No, thank you. I don't need it. I'm good over here, fam. I'm good over here. But I am an alchemist. Make sure you're clear. I am a magical alchemist, and I'm also an energy alchemist. Make sure you're clear about that so you know what you're dealing with. So when you send over all that negative shit this way, I'm just taking that shit, alchemizing that shit, and then going out here and doing things. There's a lot of shit that I don't allow y'all to see on my Instagram. I don't allow y'all to see what's really good with me out here. I don't let y'all see that because I know it incites jealousy and hate. So I don't allow a lot of things for you. I don't allow for you guys not to see much about me. You just see me on the screen saying whatever it is I got to do. You might see me take a little trip or two or something like that. But you guys have no idea. The Creator has blessed my life. I am trying to help and assist bless your life by paying it forward. That doesn't mean that I'm going to run my life into the ground for any of y'all. That's not what that means. I still have to protect my energy. Not everything can be real. That is correct. It's not necessary. Or clones. Damn, Serious Scotty said something. He said too many people don't realize that they themselves are clones. Wow. Wow. Hey, Universal Ghost. I have a great deal of gratitude for every last one of my followers. I really am appreciative of all of you. Like, real talk. Much gratitude to all of y'all. You know, I'm very humbled at the fact that you guys have supported me thus far. You guys always have to know this about me. Always. You know what I'm saying? But that other energy, I can't really rock with that other energy. And I just really want you guys to take some time out and start really looking at yourselves and know that you are somebody as well. That you are worth gold and diamonds and much more than that. Because you are in the image of the Creator. You are the Creator. Okay? You have the ability to manifest. It's like the Creator's out here creating universes and universes and planets and solar systems and all that. You're like a fraction of the Creator. So you have the ability to manifest your life any way that you want it to be. Don't allow anything external of you to tell you otherwise. That's people, places, and things. Don't allow people to even put that on you. Because whatever you tap yourself into, 99.9% of the time, you're going to manifest that into your life because of the law of attraction. So if you are getting caught up in the pandemic, getting caught up in fake-ass distorted numbers, and I'm going to say it just like that, manipulation of that, the whole nine, a lot of the reasons why people are going through the things they're going through right now is because of fear. That's like 85% of this process. It's because of fear. When you fear something, that negative energy will stop you from manifesting because now you're distracted by the fear of what you think could happen but has not happened in your life at all. I want you guys to really think about this for a second. Most people are afraid of things that never even occurred in their life. Shit that never happened in their life, things that never manifested in their life. Y'all think about that? You're fearing something that's never, ever manifested in your life. People die out here every day. Right? But we now know that a lot of the stuff that was being reported was made up due to people doing the agencies needing more money for funding. Things like that. Y'all need to start looking a little bit deeper before you start buying into certain narratives. You guys need to start looking a little bit deeper instead of just going on the surface of what you're being told on the surface. You need to go deep in depth and do some research about exactly what it is that you're, the information that you're getting from when it comes to outside sources that you know that are in direct opposition to you as a human being. You're going to want to start doing a little bit more research on that before you start buying into certain narratives. Yet their time is up. Aquarian consciousness, that is absolutely correct. Most of the people are afraid of that. And that was a programming that was put in place for a lot of people as well. Now, the body wants to live. It's going to do everything in its power. It wants to live, right? But you don't have to succumb to a lot of those things. You can begin to start working on higher things and getting higher knowledge. Now, I want to share some things with you. I was talking to my alchemist the other day. And you guys know I'm working on Solomon's Gold. And I finally got my prototype for Solomon's Gold. It is an ormus. Okay, Solomon's Gold is an ormus and an oil. So it's like two different things, ormus and oil. And I'm going to tell y'all something. I can't wait to release this product because I have other products that I'm going to be bringing out next year where I'm putting together a particular protocol. Because I heard a lot of you guys say to ask me, you know, how do I raise my vibration? How do I do this? How do I do that? Blah, 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 blah. I'm putting a series of elixirs together. Okay. These are plant-based elixirs. And mineral-based elixirs that I'm putting together that will help you elevate to certain levels where it has different functions in the body to help you activate to put you into your state of godhood, okay? I have not been talking about this to hardly anybody, but I'm telling you about this now that I do got a few things that's coming out next year. Solomon's Gold will be released next year, okay? I can't wait for you guys to see it. I can't wait for you guys to try it. I can't wait to get the feedback from you guys about this product. But I am coming up with a series of elixirs and a protocol of where you need to start if you want to start becoming more conscious. Okay. There are some things that have been going on with me that I have not been expressing to you guys in terms of information that is coming to me. There are even people that are coming to me because of the frequency I'm operating on. There are people that are now coming to me to help me along this journey of getting this information out and also the products out to you guys in terms of helping you elevate to your state of godhood. Okay. This is not for the faint of heart. I'm going to let you know right now. I hope a lot of you guys have started working on doing your shadow work, things like that. Because this is not for the faint of heart. This is for those who are really trying to get to higher levels of consciousness and higher levels of thought. All right. With going into the age of Aquarius, the world is becoming a lot more conscious of itself. The world is becoming a lot more spiritual. And so I'm here to assist you in transitioning into that space where you're operating in that space a good bit. Okay, because we're not going into 5D just yet. We got a lot of unfinished business right now, and we've been held back by a lot of different things because the people still don't want to let go of their fear. And if you're still holding on to your fear, which is a lower vibrational frequency, you stunt your growth. Okay, if you're still operating under certain religious constructs, it's going to stunt your growth because you're operating in a certain particular box. So if you're not able to be more open past that construct, you are limiting yourself to only a certain level of consciousness. You won't be able to get any higher outside the box that you place around yourself by staying within a particular way of thought. Okay? So in order for us to switch into 5D, we all have to get on one accord, or at least majority of us have to get on one accord to switch to 5D. Because the 5D, we understand that you're operating in pure consciousness. Godhood. Okay? That means that you transcended beyond this. Okay? That's what that means. You transcended. You mastered this. You mastered the flesh. You mastered that. Okay? According to consciousness, you're absolutely correct. And those people that will not be able to let go of it, that's going to be unfortunate for those individuals. What I'll say to those who are in that space, the best advice I would give you is to try to stay as open as you possibly can. You're going to need to. And you're going to start. If I don't know if you guys are seeing what's happening. And I've been seeing it in the comments about the people spazzing out, getting more negative by the day. Has anybody else been observing this, where the people are getting more and more negative? Has anybody else been experiencing or seeing this? I'll be saving it, Bigato. I always save my lives, baby. A spiritual baddie, you've been seeing it? Damn, a lot of y'all. Wow. And there's still a trap between 3D and 4D, so people need to get out and find a mentor to help them find the blind spots. Well, sweetheart, those people that are trapped between 3D and 4D already got taken up off this planet by that parallel Earth. I put that up on my Instagram. I even did a live talking about that. That's a lot of people were taken off the planet already, and more people are going to continue to keep being removed off the planet. CERN, the people who work for CERN and those powers that be are not playing with none of y'all. Okay, they're not playing. They can't come up off the planet, but they can create another parallel universe, and they have successfully done that. That's been done. The only thing they haven't done right was they didn't properly terraform it yet. This is real. I want you guys to understand, this is very real. This is not no made-up shit. This is real, real talk. And the funny thing is that I'm seeing that there's some other people that peaked it too. So I want you guys to understand that this is very real. Those who are between 3D and 4D, they're already up out of here already. And this was already told to a lot of people to keep their wits about them. Thank you, Anitra7122. Disco Dave, I see you. Global Black Girl, I see you. The problem with people are they're too scared to change and accept their faults. And I don't even understand that. Because at this stage in the game where we are now, you can't be in a position where you're afraid to accept your faults and the things you've done. We all have a little bit of ugliness within us. Okay? The key thing here is to work through the traumas of what it was that happened so you can continue to move forward. That's key. Okay? That's all that needs to be done. Because the only person that's passing judgment on yourself is yourself. See, that's the thing that people don't understand. Y'all so worried about being judged by other people when that's really not what's happening here. What's really happening here is that you've already judged yourself. So you're concerned about how the people are going to judge you and how the people are going to treat you or see you because you've already judged yourself. You don't even realize that's what you've done. This is about you forgiving yourself. There are many people out here in the world, in spite of what this thing is, there are many people in the world that are manifesting. They're manifesting their heaven. They're being very, very prosperous in their life. And they're not paying attention to all the stuff that people are afraid of. They see it. Don't get it twisted. They see it. They're aware of it. But they're not taking time and hours and putting themselves in situations to focus on that which they know is not going to help them prosper. So if you guys want to begin to start prospering, then what you got to do is that you got to change the dial and the frequency that you're operating on. But you got to change the dial of what you're focusing on and stop focusing on it. Change the dial. Turn the channel, fam. Then what you do is you take the time out, and as you're doing your shadow work, so you're in the midst of manifesting, you could do a vision board. Some people use vision boards. Some people write things out, okay, with a pen and a piece of paper. Some things write things out. Let me give an example. Now I'm going to share some magic with you. If you want to manifest something in your life, okay, and make sure you're realistic with your manifestation. Start off with something small. Okay? Don't be out here talking about, I want to get a Lamborghini tomorrow. Don't be stupid out here. Don't be silly out here. Okay? But what I want you to do is get a white candle. This is white magic. Get a white candle. Get a brown paper bag. And write down your wish of what you would like to see happen for yourself. Okay, whatever it is that you're wishing for. So if you wish to get a higher paying job, okay, make sure you're specific about the type of job that you want. Don't just write, I would like to get a higher paying job, and you're a secretary, and then someone comes and hits you talking about they want to hire you to operate cranes at $50 an hour, and you're a secretary making $25 an hour. Like, use some common sense, okay? Use some common sense. Yeah, sit in your intentions. That is correct. Make sure you use a number two pencil, because number two pencils are what? They're made from what? Hollywood. Hollywood means what? Magic wand. Okay? So you want to get a number two pencil. You want to write on the brown paper bag. You want to get yourself a candle. And you want to set the candle on that brown paper bag for probably about 3 to 7 days. This is called white magic. This is not it for anything who's trying to cause harm to someone. That's not what this is for, and it won't work. Okay? This is strictly about you manifesting what it is that you're trying to accomplish for your life. Okay? For those of you that have businesses, you guys need to start doing some clearing work on yourself, and you also need to start doing some clearing work over your business. Okay? Do some research. Did someone just ask me what is a number two pencil? Do you remember when you were in school and they told you to use the number two pencil, the pencil with the number two on it? Like when you were doing the SATs? That's called the number two pencil. Now, you also can get some parchment paper, okay? And what you're going to do is, when you're done writing out what it is that you want, when you're done writing it out, you're going to take the paper and you're going to fold it towards you. So you're going to fold it one way, then turn it around, fold it the next way, then turn around, but make sure you're folding everything towards you so the blessing comes towards you, okay? That's how you do that. Yeah, we're using a mechanical pencil. Okay, that's all you have to do. This is straight basic magic. This is basic shit. Like, this is like basic. For those of you that are new and you have a lot of negative energy around you, you need to take a clearing bath. All right, a clearing bath. So the way you do that is you get some goat's milk, use half a pint of the goat's milk, some water. You're going to pour it in a large bowl. I talked about this before, but I'm going to talk about it again because I know some of y'all don't forget. get a big bowl, a big plastic bowl, or a big pot, something like that. You use half goat's milk, water. Get some Florida water or whatever Colonia calls out to you. Preferably, I use Florida water. Get some efun or cascarilla. You can get that at a Botanica. Those are eggshells. Those are crushed eggshells. Okay? Some white flowers. Some hyssop. Or look for some other cleansing herbs. And you're going to put it in the bath. And you're going to say a prayer and ask that the bath clear all negative energy from the body. You're going to do it 3 times in a row. Listen to me carefully. 3 times in a row. You are going to stir it with your hand. You're going to pray into it. And you're going to tell the bath to clear you. Now you will let the bath sit at room temperature all day. You're not going to take this bath until nighttime before you go to bed. Because it's going to put you to sleep literally within 15 to 20 minutes after you've taken the bath. All right. Once you do this, the first thing you're going to do is, before you take this bath, wash your ass first and get all the regular funk up off your asses. Okay, do that first. Then when you're done with that, then you take the water and have somebody help you and pour the water over top of your crown chakra all the way down your body. Now, it's going to be cold, and it's supposed to be cold. And don't you cheating asses go out here and try to warm the damn water up, because you're going to mess the bath up. It's supposed to be at room temperature. Okay? It's supposed to be at room temperature. Pour it over top of the body, pat dry. Don't just dry yourself off. Pat dry, because you want the medicine to stay on your body. Pat dry. Okay, if you got a fan in your bedroom, turn on the fan. Air dry. Pat dry. Okay? Cover yourself up with a white cloth. Put some white sheets on your bed. And majority of y'all should already be sleeping with white sheets in your bed. None of y'all should be sleeping with any darkness on your beds whatsoever. Because this year, from here until June, if you are sleeping with anything that is dark, it can bring sickness and diseases to you and illnesses. Because a lot of people don't understand that some of the stuff comes from the atmosphere. Okay? Some of the stuff comes from the atmosphere. So you want to make sure that you always have white sheets when you're in the bed and you're sleeping, or the brightest color sheets you can find. Okay? Take your ass to damn Target, Walmart, maybe even the dollar store or something, and get your ass some white sheets. That's a form of actual spiritual medicine for those who want to keep themselves sick free. You can also order Florida water on Amazon. You can go to any botanic, you can go to any grocery store, they sell it. It's called Florida water. You get Colonia 1800. It just depends on what, for those of you that are in the knowledge, I already know what I'm talking about. For those that are new, Google Botanica in your city and see what Botanica. I didn't say botanicals. I said Botanica. Okay? You'll know what a botanic is. It's a little spiritual shop that you can go to, and they got all these damn statues and stuff in there. The Orisha and saints and shit up in there and all types of stuff. Go take your ass up in there and see if they got some Florida water. Or go to any grocery store or what have you and get that. And see if they got some cascarilla, because they sell cascarilla in there too. You can use some bay rum. That is correct. Make sure that you have the bath sitting out at room temperature. So that means that if you create the bath in the morning, let it set out throughout the whole day. In front of your altar if you have one. If you don't have one, like I set mine in front of my ancestor's shrine. And let them do things to it. You know what I'm saying? I'll be telling them, I was like, go ahead, do. This is what I need you to do. Tell them to do things. For those of you all who have your ancestor altar, tell them that you need them to bless it. That you need them to bless your bath for you. Okay? You want to do this bath until you feel completely clean. 3 days to 7 days at the most. You're going to feel very light. You're not going to feel heavy. Now, you guys also should do some floor washes. I hope you got me something. Okay. You guys need to start doing floor washes on your floors. you guys should, okay, I'm teaching y'all something about getting yourself prepped for your environment. You should have a clean environment. You should not have a bunch of cluttered up shit in your house, in your room. Clear it out. Okay? Clear it out. Get rid of clothes that got holes in them and shit like that. Get rid of all that shit. Take it outside. Burn it in the backyard somewhere. If you can't burn it, dump it in the trash can. Get rid of anything that has old energy from negative and past things, because now this is a new time that you're entering into your life. You got December the 14th when you're coming into the age of Aquarius. That is a sign that we're going into Aquarius. Then you got the 21st through the 25th. And there's going to be a lot of consciousness coming down amongst the people. But for those of you who are not open to consciousness, you're going to have a hard time. So I suggest you start figuring out how you're going to get more open. Because if you're digressing and you're getting more negative, that's not going to be a good look for you, because that's during the time period where I told you everything splits. Now, I saw a video floating around where they were talking about the Earths looking like basic orbs, and you could see the orbs that were going to be splitting. First of all, that's not accurate. That's not accurate. You guys have to understand that the only thing that's splitting is that those who are operating in three-dimensional will be in three-dimensional. Those who are operating in 4D consciousness and higher will be in that space. That's how that's going to go. So those that are operating on 3D consciousness, there's going to be a cap, a ceiling energetic-wise, because you didn't do your work. And you're not going to be able to break that. You're not going to be able to break that until you do what you're supposed to do. You're going to be mad. You're going to be frustrated. You're going to be mad at everybody else. You better make sure you get your shit together. Okay? So what's splitting is very simple. It's just simply the dimensions. Okay? Are you still going to see people? Yes, you're going to see people. Of course you're going to see people. But it's going to seem very strange, because those who are much more on a higher conscious level, a lot of those people that they were associating with is going to seem very, very far away from them. Like, things that are very far, far away from me now is the presidency. I don't pay no attention to that shit at all. It's far away from me now. I don't even know what the hell is going on. The vaccine, I don't know what's going on. It's far away from me. I'm not even tuned into it. It literally has shifted me completely away from anything like that. I'm shifted completely away from it. When people ask me, did you hear about this? I don't know what the hell is going on. I tell people all the time, no, I didn't know. I don't know what the hell's going on. I don't know. Okay? You also want to practice making sure, for those of you who are not sleeping at night, make sure that you cut your Wi-Fi off at night when you sleep, because it is a disruptor from you dreaming. So cut your Wi-Fi off when you sleep at night. Turn your phone off. Turn your Wi-Fi off. Make sure you're not looking at the blue light before you go to bed, things like that. For those of you that are also having issues of humming in the ears, make sure that you do a metal detox. I recently found out through some study and research that that is a cause of ringing in the ears. You may have too many metals within the body. Make sure that you are doing metal detoxes. You can do an ionic foot bath. Do some research on how to detox metals out of the body. That is very, very important. Okay? EMF protection crystals do help. That is correct. Chelation, that is correct. Chelation is a really good one. Activated charcoal, cranial sacral work. See, look at the people that are in the comments, y'all. They're dropping some science about different things you guys could do. And I want to say shout out to those that are in the knowledge. Please share your knowledge base with my followers, because that's how you make a community work. Okay? So please share that information. One person is saying milk thistle. Ionic foot bath. Google it. My eyes for 30 minutes, I was only seeing sparkles around everything. I was looking at, is there something wrong with me? There's nothing wrong with you, baby. Infrared saunas, lemon water with apple cider vinegar, spirulina, chlorophyll. Exactly. See, I wanted you guys, yeah, I went in at the beginning. I had to get that off me real quick. But see, I shifted off that energy. Now, y'all pay attention how I shifted off the energy? I just want to, because really what this is about, I'd rather put my energy and time into giving you the valuable knowledge that you need to continue to help you progress and prosper. Okay? Someone said breath work is good. Phytoplankton is okay. School me. I don't know what phytoplankton is. Someone break that down because I don't know. Auntie, how do I go about getting a spiritual reading from you? From me, you're going to have to wait till next year, baby. Now, I do money spiritual consultations. I do those for those of you that are having issues manifesting. I got some people in this live that's taking that court, that's taking that with me. And literally, folks is getting paid. Their money is like rolling in with no problems. I do that. That's on the website, shopwithaccesswisdom.com. You can do that. And then, like I said, for those who just have advice, want advice and they want to talk to me, I got Ask Isis on the website. But the only spiritual consultations I'm doing right now are the money consultations. I can't take on any spiritual consultations right now because I got too many people I'm helping right now. Okay, hold on. Phytoplankton aids in photosynthesis. Okay. Thank you for schooling me on that. Mediterranean oregano oil, black seed oil. Yep, those are good. Brock, which one of your baths we can use for clearing negative energy? Are you on the live? Yeah. Okay, they're asking you what baths can they get. Okay. Fasting with certain herbs is good. Shunganite. At Yuli150, please answer your message. I'll go tag me on Instagram, fam, so I know to go. Yeah, make sure you do your research on your supplements and stuff like that as well. Sea moss is great. The money consultation is the best. Absolutely worth it. Thank you, Global Black Girl. She knows because she took it. Yeah, I'm serious about that. His salt, rosemary, Florida water, sea salt for basic cleansing. Now, my daughter does have some dope spiritual bath products that you guys can get off her website. Shameless plug, but I'm going to do it anyway because she's got some very good products. Log on to BarackyElvesGarden.com or hit her Instagram. When you see her talking, just hit her Instagram. Go to her Instagram and then go to her website. Oh, this is a new one?
Yep.
The new Angel Tears. Which one is this? This is the father and son?
No, that's the mother.
This is still the mother of the moon?
Mm-hmm.
This is still the mother of the moon? Oh, okay. So she's got new Angel Tears out, y'all. But this is still the mother of the moon. I thought she released the father and the son. You're not doing it to the summer? That's next year? Okay. So I want to make sure you guys see this as well. Angel Tears that will help with any type of depression, any type of negative energy that you might be dealing with, lucid dreamings,
healing.
What else? Okay, yeah, type it in the comments. But make sure y'all check it out. And no, this is not real angel tears. No angels were hurt in the process of making this. We just want to let y'all know. No angels were harmed or hurt in any way while processing this. Huh? Well, I can only feel the spirit come over me and protect me. A spiritual bat. Yeah, angel tears ain't no joke. She does work with real angels. They just not crying and we not taking their tears and stuff on us. So we just going to take tears or squeeze them and just give us the tip. We're not doing any of that. I think we get our asses whooped if we try that. Yeah, those beings ain't to be played with. Let's squeeze them up. Give me them damn tears. Okay, I'm just... What's he say? Where angels we get the tears from? Hits up as an herb, baby, but you can get it in oil form. Nah, they really said that. They was dead ass serious about it, fam. What angels? What tears you get? What angels you get the tears from? babes. I got 16 seconds. Love y'all. Hope I gave y'all enough information. Holla back. Check out my website, shopiceswisdom.com. Peace.